next, it's a bantamweight title fight between Henan Barão and TJ Dillashaw. So here's the number one bantamweight contender making his way to the octagon. Got to be some nerves here as he gets set to compete for the UFC bantamweight title. No denying he deserves to be there. He's got the requisite win streak. He's got the finishes. He's got the popularity, the fan support. Now he needs the championship performance. We'll see if he has what it takes to unseat the incumbent. Here he is, the UFC bantamweight champion. He has successfully defended the title in the past. A decidedly different challenge, though, here tonight. Prevailing wisdom is that this will be his toughest title defense to date. The odds suggest that this is a close matchup on paper, but he believes he's one of the GOATs, one of the greatest of all time. If you want to be that, you certainly got to make good on this title defense tonight. Tell the tape for this bantamweight championship fight. Barão is 27. Dillashaw is 34. Barão will have a 3-inch reach advantage. Now for the official introductions, the veteran voice of the octagon, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Dan Mergliotta. And now, this is the moment you've all been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Toyota Center in Houston, Texas, it's time! Five rounds for the undisputed UFC Bantamweight Championship of the World. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 18 wins, 4 losses. He stands 5 feet 6 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of Denver, Colorado, presenting the challenger, TJ Dillashaw. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a mixed martial artist, holding a professional record of 36 wins, 9 losses, and 1 no contest. He stands 5 feet 6 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, ladies and gentlemen, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC bantamweight champion of the world, Henan the Baron Barão!
All right, this is for the UFC championship. I want you to do my commands at all times, protect yourself at all times. Want a nice, clean, safe fight. Touch gloves, back your corners, come out fighting.
They are so well-rounded, they have every skill, and that is going to be on display tonight in this key matchup.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman. Look at him whip his hip into that kick. He loaded up there on that high kick.
Nice 1-2 combination there. Oh, straight right. A little single collar tie there. Nice combination of elbows to the head. Back to the feet now. Oh, collar tie. Oh! Big shots exchanged in the pocket there. Well, we'll see if he can turn this defense into offense.
Wow, actually got the takedown. Oh!
Oh, what a beautiful counter to the guillotine there. Gets side mount, and now maybe the Von Flu choke will be there. Alvin St. Preux has got to like that transition there. Not tapping out tonight. All right, full guard now, DC.
And for the guy on top, he needs to build posture or just go to the next position, start shoving that knee through, trying to get the half guard, which in turn will lead to more opportunities for advancement. But if you're on the bottom, you need to be anticipating.
Oh, Corral's trying for a submission here.
The problem with rolling leg lock in MMA, man, is you get beat up, especially if you're a little bit hurt.
He might get a finish here. And this might just be a matter of time. Brilliant submission defense there.
Now it's his mount.
Well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. Just over 2 minutes to go in round one. Beautiful movement, hip work on the ground here, just outstanding with the transition.
He is not staying in one place on the ground. That's very important.
Right inside his opponent's guard here, DC. You don't want to play around here too long.
No, you got to either have two hands in or two hands out, or guys start to attack triangle.
Close guard. Well, he continues to manhandle him here on the ground. 90 seconds to go. Oh, nice job working hard, posting, and getting back up.
Oh, he's back in the clinch. Look for him to get that right hand busy.
All right, he closes the distance, gets the single collar tie. Timing his shots nicely here, champ.
He's doing a great job of mixing everything up and using a lot of diverse strikes.
Some nice back and forth action here.
He gets to his spot, the tie pull. Then he starts to let the knees fly.
Taken down by Dillashaw. And they both stand up.
Dig and kick. Oh, my God.
Much improved defensively as he blocks the shot. Well, straight right hand has been a good weapon for him. He misses with it there. Dillashaw gets caught with that punch. He'd be wise to get those hands up. Slips. Round one winding down here. That horn sounds means we have reached the end of round one. Let's look back at some of the action in that round, DC. What a high-level display of offensive wrestling.
I mean, this is a joy for me to watch. I enjoy watching a guy maintain this level of wrestling for as long as he has done this. He is constantly in his opponent's face. He's constantly taking him down. Getting taken down and getting up is exhausting. Let's see how tired his opponent is at the start of the next round.
Corral gets caught with that punch. He's treading water now. Got to find a way to move those feet.
Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks.
Punch is blocked. Well, it's one thing to have length. It's another thing to use it, and he does it as well as anyone. Nice kick there by Dillashaw. He has landed some good shots, DC, but really unable to string anything together in terms of...
That's a perfect scramble right there. Beautiful transition.
Oh, spinning back fist. He didn't telegraph that one at all. Pretty good knee to the body by Dillashaw. All right, he engages in the single collar tie.
Of the transition. Nice scramble.
Just missed with the left there.
That's a big strike right there.
Got the single collar tie.
Right hand punch from the clinch.
All right, so again, the fighters clinch here. Kind of had an inkling we'd find ourselves back in this situation.
Absolutely. Both of these fighters love fighting chest to chest. The uglier the fight, the better.
Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there. Just over 3 minutes to go now. Back to the left hand now. Unable to connect. Oh, nice connection there with a punch, DC.
Great time to land that punch.
And they separate. Oh, nice slip there. Great head movement overall by this guy defensively.
He does a great job of moving his head side to side, really mixing up the motion at which he moves.
Dillashaw going for the leg kick. He misses. Man, as he landed a high volume of strikes here in round two, definitely picking up the pace at... Oh! Oh!
Beautiful strike.
Dillashaw's lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling. Able to check the high kick. Oh, now gets an underhook to get a more dominant position. Boy, time clock. Whoa!
Serve him up. Go get him. Every time these guys come together, man, you just hear the punches and everything landing. Both very powerful.
Yeah, looks a little wobbly on his feet. Oh! Back to the feet.
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Oh, nice scramble by him there. Takedown defense on point. He is a master in transition. Oh, single collar tie here.
Notice the drive. Look at how they drive the knee right into the midsection.
Nice punch there by Hennen Barrett. Kick to the body now. That one won't land.
Liver kick. Oh, nice.
Oh, really good job by him there to raise the guard, DC, and block those shots coming his way.
He does a great job blocking all incoming strikes.
Oh, he lands another strike to the body, really starting to connect on a lot of shots to the midsection, and these will take their toll as this fight goes into the latter rounds. Nice hook. Big knee to the body. Went for the inside leg kick.
That's a great punch. Does a lot of damage when you can hit him in the body that clean.
Oh, beautiful strike there as he lands up top, and he does so right after catching the leg. So maybe you thought he would catch the leg and go for a takedown. Instead, he goes for the punch, and he certainly found the range on that one.
Big punch land.
And
now he engages in a Muay Thai clinch, and I think a lot of people watching wonder how you can control an opponent like that. Hard to get out of.
It's very difficult to get out of. Look and notice how tight his elbows are as he's maneuvering and moving his opponent into positions where he can get off the strikes.
All right, let's check out some of the action, DC, and how about the punching acumen by that fighter in that previous round?
He does not waste anything. He does not loop punches. Everything's tight. Everything's precise. He's a sniper. We always talk about how he's a sniper. He is a sniper, and it showed in that exchange that allowed him to drop his opponent.
Here we go, third round of this championship fight. Well, he hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down tonight. He continues to connect on a high volume of strikes here. Oh! Huge right hand!
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Cole! Dillashaw goes for the clinch here. Looks like he's trying to recover. He was stunned a little bit earlier. Let's see if he can get a respite here.
Oh,
big knee.
Beautiful body.
Takedown, no problem.
Great punch landed with so much power.
Oh, another strike to the body. Not a lot of real estate there, but he found it. Dillashaw's lower jaw is extremely swollen now. Oh, and there's a takedown attempt, DC. Not a great one. Might as well tell your opponent you're shooting, huh?
Yeah, he's your best friend. Tell him that you want to take him to his back and watch him defend and then beat you up with the fight stand. Right hand punch to the clinch.
Both fighters exchange in the pocket here. Nice kick landed there by Dillashaw. Left hook to the hook. Execution on the strike that ultimately results in the KO here. All right, let's take a look back at the replay. It ends up a knockout, but this was really a striking clinic from the moment they touched glove.
I mean, a competitive fight. That one guy finally found the shot that ended the fight, but both of these warriors displayed a ton of heart. One guy got the finish, but neither guy should be disappointed in their performance.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mogliano is going to stop this contest at 1:50 of the third round. Playing the winner by knockout and new undisputed UFC bantamweight champion of the world, DJ Dillashaw.
All right, so there it is. Bruce Buffer makes it official. We have a new UFC bantamweight champion. Seems like everything he said to us in our fighter meeting on Thursday came to fruition here on Fight.
He was so confident that he was going to get the job done. This was one of the best performances in a title fight that I've ever seen a challenger have to become champion.